Shot down in a blaze of hot cross bungs, Phil Taylor was denied the Hollywood finale to his glittering career. And as Rob Cross became the finest purveyor of arrows from Hastings since King Harold copped one in the eye from William the Conqueror in 1066, a shooting star was born at Alexandra Palace. In his 21st final, and last competitive match before he retires today at the age of 57, Taylor crashed 7-2 in the final of the William Hill PDC Darts World Championship at Alexandra Palace. If destiny had smiled on the power's passage to the final curtain toppled on him like a ton of bricks. Instead of the Beverly Hills climax he craved, 16 times world champion Taylor got a Muswell Hill send-off into the sunset. Cross, 27, need feel no embarrassment about desecrating a legend's swan song with a rout. He's not the man who shot Bambi, he's the former electrician who is suddenly the brightest spark in the pack. If Cross had turned off the power so abruptly 12 months ago, when he was in darts amateur ranks, the Southern Electricity Board would not have been impressed. Now they should be putting his name in lights. Cross invited Taylor to lift the Sid Waddell trophy with him and gasped, "I hadn't even been born, or taken my first breath of air, when Phil won his first world title in 1990. You will never see another sportsman like him, that's why I invited him to lift the trophy with me. But I don't just want this to be my first world title. I want to push the boat out, win them all and become world number one. S." Cross inflicted the heaviest defeat in the final since Taylor thrashed Raymond van Barneveld 7-1 9 years ago, and his performance was phenomenal, averaging a fabulous 107.67 and knocking out 60% of his doubles as if he was shelling peas. This was the first time Taylor had ever played Cross, and he will be grateful it was the last. He won just 10 legs all night. But when you've won 123 out of 136 contests at the World Championship, who's counting? For Cross, life will never be the same. Married at 21, and a father of three, he didn't have two plug sockets to rub together 12 months ago, but this morning he is and pound, 400,000 richer. His sudden death semi-final thriller, which toppled reigning champion Michael van Gerwen well past midnight on Saturday, was the most pulsating duel between two slavheads since Phil and Grant Mitchell fought over Sharon Watts' affections on EastEnders. And now he has climbed the PDC charts faster than any Christmas phenomenon since Band-Aid. From the outset, Cross wasn't falling for any of Taylor's mind games. Even when the power won the pre-match bullseye contest backstage for the right to throw first, and handed the young pretender first use of the darts to put him under pressure, he didn't buckle. Cross refused to be intimidated by Taylor's and pound, 7.3 million career prize money, his 102 TV titles and his attempts to unsettle him with eye contact on stage. Just as Taylor had ambushed his mentor Eric Bristow 6-1 in the final as a 125-1 outsider 28 years ago to win the first of his 16 world titles, Cross simply refused to bow and curtsy to a legend. When the raced into a three-set lead, taking out 167 and 153 as if he was peeling a tangerine, Taylor admitted he was terrified of bowing out with a humiliating 7-0 whitewash. Although the power stopped the rot by taking the fourth set, the belief drained out of him like bathwater after pulling the plug in the very next leg. Instead of blowing the roof off Ally Pally with a sensational 9-darter, he wired double 12. And as if to prove this was not to be the power's night, he scattered his next half-dozen arrows across the board like a bag of spanners falling out of the loft, and Cross stole the leg with exemplary ruthlessness. History will not judge Taylor on an old stager's last stand falling horribly flat. Roger Federer can keep his 19 Grand Slam titles. Jack Nicklaus can keep his 18 majors. Don Bradman can keep his test batting average of 99.94, even when he was soundly beaten. Taylor averaged 102.26 last night. The power's achievements, and especially his longevity, will stand the test of time against all of them. But when Cross took out 140 on double 16, the electrician who caused a huge short circuit on the power grid became the new monarch in the town where King Harold snuffed it the last time Britain was invaded. The king is dead, long live the king.